We need to protect astronauts from space radiation. Now, that space radiation can come from primarily two places. One is from our own sun. It spews out mainly protons, but it also those magnetic fields that come out from the sun also entrain other things. But also from outside the solar system, even it's called galactic cosmic radiation, it is very high energy and it can penetrate spacecraft walls, it penetrates bodies. What we're trying to figure out is how big does that magnetic field have to be in order to protect astronauts inside that magnetic field? And then what materials can we use to generate those magnetic fields? How are we going to then package all that into a spacecraft and actually launch it? If we could get this technology to work and to be able to keep our astronauts safe on this mission, we could extend the mission or at least keep the astronauts below their radiation limits. This is the first time it's actually been thought from an engineering point of view all the way through. We can start looking at magnetic shielding and the engineering concerns that go along with that. So we're looking at things like thermal issues. Are we going to have a sun shield? How much is that going to weigh? How are we going to attach it to the spacecraft? How are we going to dissipate the heat generated by the humans and all the equipment necessary to keep the magnets cold? How are we going to handle quenching? How are we going to package all this onto a rocket? How much is it going to weigh? How much, you know, et cetera. The next step then is to create a technology demonstrator that we could, say, launch and put onto International Space Station to test out everything, actually have a radiation protection experiment on ISS. What did our calculations say versus what real hardware says, which is always something you need to do in new and exciting things that really haven't been done before.